As part of learning reactive form, in the previous video, we linked the form element with the form group object of the component class. In this video, we will include an input text element for name and link it with the name field of the form group object. In app.component.html, within the form tag, I am including a div tag with content as name. This will act as the label for name input text element. In the next line, I am including input tag with type as text, then including form control name with value as name. Let us understand about form control name. In angular.io, I am in the documentation of form control name. It is a directive from Reactive Forms module. Its selector is form control name, which is what we have defined in the input text element as an attribute. This directive helps to link a form element with a form control object. Let me highlight how the linking happens internally using a diagram. We can see the main code snippet from app.component.html and app.component.ts. The form control name directive first identifies the enclosing form tag. From the enclosing form, it gets the respective form group object. Once it has got the form group object, it fetches its value name and looks into the form group object and looks for a form control that has name as its property. Once it finds the matching entry, it gets the respective form control object and links it with the input text element. From this diagram, it is clear that form control name is not directly referring to a property in the component class. Hence, it does not have the property binding square bracket syntax. Hope this helps to understand how the form control name directive works. Let me go back to Visual Studio Code. I am saving the file. After the page reload in the browser, we can see the input text element displayed with appropriate label. To check if it is working correctly, in app.component.ts, within the constructor parameter of form control, I am including some sample name within the empty string. The first constructor parameter of form control contains the value of the form element. Let us see if this name is reflected in the input text element. I am saving the file. After the page reload, we can see the respective sample name pre-populated in the input text element, which means that we have successfully linked the input text element with the form control object. I am reverting back the name included in the form control object and saving the file. In app.component.html, include the input text element with form control name directive with value as name, then check if it works by including some name in the form control object. And then move on to the next video.